Okay, so what is a fraction?
A fraction is a part of a whole.
There are actually two portions of a fraction. There's the numerator and also the denominator. In a fraction, the numerator and denominator tell us very important things.
All right, so what is a numerator and denominator? Let's look at a fraction right here. Before we start, here's a couple different representations of this fraction. What do you notice? What do you think the numerator is and the denominator is? All right, let's look at a model that matches this fraction. The numerator is the number of pieces that is actually represented or that we have. The denominator actually represents how many equal pieces are in a whole. Something to remember when we're talking about fractions is we are talking about equal parts. So the denominator is going to tell you how many equal parts we will have in the whole, and the numerator tells you how many equal parts you actually have. Here are multiple different representations of this fraction. You can also show fractions as a part of a group. Let's look at this picture right now. What fraction do you think this is showing? How do you think this represents a fraction? What do you notice? There's three lines. So in this group, three out of the entire group, which has five, are limes. You could also look at it the other way. You could say two of the group is lemons, so two out of the five are lemons. Let's look at a few other parts of a group. What do you notice? What's the same? What's different? Three of these chocolates in this chocolate box are squares. There's six chocolates in the box total, so our fraction is 3/6.
All right, let's try this one.
All right, so there's four chocolates total in this chocolate box, so our denominator is going to be 4. Now we're going to say that there's 3 square chocolates, so our fraction's going to be 3/4. If we were going to say the fraction of the circle chocolate, that would be 1/4.